As Filipino consumers battle high inflation, it seems bread prices are becoming another source of sticker shock for grocery shoppers. And this morning, we're going to talk about bread, which is a staple of life and of sharing around the world with very few ingredients and produced very close to the consumer. The French baker founder and head of Phil Baking, John Lucoa, thank you so much for joining us, John Lu. Hi, good morning.
Morning, Mimi.
All right. So, John Lu, a baker friend once told me that the law of bread is simple. You maintain the weight and adjust the price, or you maintain the price but lower the weight. It seems like the bakers these days are doing both, shrinking the size of pandesal while raising prices.
Well, that's not exactly true.
Okay.
Especially among the big bakers.
Okay.
We represent the country's 10 biggest bakeries in the Philippines.
Mm-hmm.
And that's exactly what we did not want to do.
To shrink
the size.
We told
the members, don't shrink it. Because we're all of us are long-term players. We did not just open our stores yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
And we've been here long enough to know that consumer franchise, or the belief of the consumer about the goodness of a brand, is assures long-term survival for the company.
All right, so you don't agree with shrinking the size, but you are pushing for increasing the price. I know that your group is filing for a 4 peso increase on top of the 3 peso increase in February. What's the latest on that?
Oh, yes, tomorrow we shall be submitting our letter to Secretary Pascual.
All right.
It's been a more than 2 months wait because we did not want to submit the request just when the new administration came in. We thought that we still had enough resources to support tame the inflation that DTI secretary would like to see.
That's right. And the 4 peso increase, when realistically speaking, when do you expect that to take effect?
Anytime during the month of September would be okay with us.
All right.
I think DTI would need to study, to look at the changes of the price of flour, sugar, and cost of labor, electricity, the cost of bringing the goods from factory to market. For example, toll fees, traffic situation, you know, all of these contribute to lowering our
margins.
Yes.
John Lu, you mentioned the ingredients. I know that baking has very few ingredients. You've got salt, which we import, sugar, locally produced, water. There's yeast. I know that except for artisanal bread, we import yeast as well. And then the wheat flour, which you also import. Which among these ingredients would you say are putting the most pressure on your costs today? I understand there is no shortage. There is no shortage in these ingredients. It's just that the prices are just so high.
Yeah, there's no shortage. As Congressman Joey said a while ago, it's just really the shifting to the right of the supply curve or to the left of the supply curve. But in any case, shifting left or right will determine the equilibrium price. So for so long as the bakers are willing to pay that price and are able to pass it on to the consumers, then the supply will be quite stable as far as bread is concerned.
And given your vantage point, what you're seeing in the next 6 to 12 months, are you seeing, you know, the inflationary pressure on your raw materials starting to ease soon, or is this going to be a problem all the way until next year and beyond?
Well, Mimi, we work very closely with our flour millers, as well as our sugar producers, I mean, sugar traders.
Okay.
We don't buy from producers because we're not big enough a group as to influence price or something like that. But we're told to just deal with the commodity traders. So individually, we're able to secure our stocks in the short and medium term. There's no such thing as long term because I believe that in the Philippines, they go from milling season to milling season. And it's something like an allocation process that's going on. So for so long as you're willing to pay for this price going forward into the future, then they can assure you of stock. But then many of us buy on the spot market. So whatever is the price you get today, it's probably the price you will get when it's delivered tomorrow.
And I guess the challenge for the big players is to move up the value chain, to go to the higher, bigger margin products instead of just the low margin bread, correct?
Yes, but in bakery production, you have a huge fixed cost. And in order to be able to recover from high fixed costs, you need some bread and butter products or products that have volume, high volume, but low contribution margin. And of course, you should also have products that have low volume with high contribution margin.
All right. John Liu, you know, they say rice is life. So is bread. How are Filipinos adjusting, you know, their consumption of bread as a result of the price adjustments? And in some cases, especially for the smaller bakers, the size changes of the bread.
Well, I would say that artisanal bakers, those bakers found in countryside as well as in the communities, they should be allowed to do what they feel is right because they are not as supported as we are. We the big bakeries have banks to support their financial needs. They have flour millers who look at long-term relationships in the pricing of their flour. And so we are in a much better position to protect our medium-term future. But the small bakers, they are most vulnerable. They can literally, get their sales of yesterday to buy their
today's raw materials
today.
Yeah.
And that's the problem.
All right. All right. John Liu,
that's your problem.
I want to shift now to the French Baker, a 33-year-old chain with over 70 branches. You've grown with the SM Mall Group story. How is business today? I mean, people are starting to go back to the malls. And is the mall model still profitable?
Definitely. The mall model is profitable in the sense that when the mall operator effectively runs the mall, then you benefit from that synergistic effect. But if the mall operator is remiss on the marketing function, then you suffer with that.
But in your case, the SM Group has considered the French Baker one of its, you know, staple brands. Every mall, most of SM malls have the French Baker, correct?
Yes, so, but of course we're also in the other malls.
That's right.
Ayala, Robinson.
Is it still Lego profitable, World. John Liu? Is the business still profitable?
Yes, actually, we have... we have every year we get to meet our lessees, lessors,
okay,
and they will tell us already that your rent is getting to be X amount of your sales. Therefore, this is a warning. This is a red flag. If you go beyond that, we may have to take you out. Imagine being told that. So internally, we have to recalibrate. We have to reinvent, we have to reorganize, whether it's menu, whether it is refurbishing your store, whether it's doing more publicity, etc. So there's internal check and balance. And conversely, we tell them all, look, if your escalators are not working, if you have smelly toilets, if you have disrespectful and discourteous guards, these all make up to poor mauling experience, which will hit us in the long run.
All right. Constant recalibration. Final question, John Liu. Are you planning to list and become a public company? Is that in the plans?
Well, right now, it is really just trying to get back to the market and to get back to the opportunities that we had left out 2 years ago.
All right. But never can tell. Thank you very much, John Liu, for joining us. Pleasure speaking with you. Have a great day ahead.
Welcome.